What sort of hope do you have of improvement in the future, locally?
We do hope that eventually they'll start. No precinct is required to keep records according to the Louisiana law now. It does say you have to keep records, but if you have a written policy that you won't racially profile, you don't have to keep records. So everyone basically has a policy that says they won't racially profile. So we're hoping we get to the point where that is not the law, that the law is you must keep records, because we do find that it actually will protect law enforcement as well. If you get accused of racial profiling and we can go back to your records and you can prove to us that you didn't, that the numbers are okay. Where now all we can go on is suspicion, because no one has these records that we need. And even for our study, a lot of times we had to go to court records. So, and actually people went to court, so we don't even know who got stopped. So it's a really interesting issue. We hope to be doing a lot with it in the future. Since the study just came out in May, anything I go to, I bring the racial profiling study, because I think it's something people need to be aware of. Because I think sometimes in Louisiana, what I've run into is people believe that the racial justice issue has kind of calmed down, and we actually see the opposite.
Are there other entities in the local area also pursuing this topic? Racial profiling
specifically, I don't think so. I think that was kind of our big thing. But there's definitely a lot of groups working towards racial justice.
Okay.
Norris Henderson runs Safe Street Strong Communities and Vote, which is teaching felons how to vote after they've been out of jail. And Safe Street Strong Communities are taking people who've been in jail and showing them kind of the way back into society. And I think any of the groups in New Orleans that work sort of with us all are kind of behind this issue, but that might not be their issue. But
yes,
the racial profiling stuff was ACLU of Louisiana. Yeah.
You mentioned another subject early on, which we have an interest in, and that has to do, I think you mentioned, either marijuana or legalization or on that topic.
Mm-hmm.
When you have such meetings on that topic, what do you what position does the ACLU take?
National has a national drug project. We don't really deal with that here, so I'm personally not that well versed in those ACLU policies. What I was doing the other day for a drugs and society class is what I do know is that the drug testing of teachers. Lafourche Parish wanted to try that a couple of months ago.
Yeah.
That's a no-no. That's completely against the Fourth Amendment. No, there's no probable cause to just drug test all teachers. We actually have a representative from Metairie right now wanting to introduce a law that you drug test all welfare recipients. And we see that as a criminalization of poverty, because his presumption is if you're poor and you're on welfare, you're gonna do drugs. And so that's the kind of stuff we work on here. We work on basic drug laws under the Fourth Amendment. Again, no probable cause to drug test every welfare recipient.
But the ACLU doesn't have a position on decriminalization of marijuana or other drugs?
I believe they do, but being new to ACLU, I've studied the
okay.
ones that we're really concentrated on to ACLU, and I haven't worked with our national drug project. So I wouldn't want to say what our position is, because I'm going to be honest, I don't know.
Well,
but I can always get back to you, and on a later show, you can.
There was a very recent Times-Picayune editorial by one of their national writers who felt like the time has come for some decriminalization.
I think that that's kind of the mindset of ACLU people. But like I said, I don't work with the National Drug Project, so I wasn't completely sure what our
position. All right. Well, we have a couple of minutes left of our half hour, which goes very fast.
Goes very fast.
What would you like to say that we haven't already covered?
I'd like people to know that we're definitely working for the people of Louisiana. Everything we do is in keeping every citizen in mind. All we are trying to do is create a fairer, more balanced Louisiana, the way that kind of the forefathers saw the way everything should work. I encourage people to join. We need members. We can't do lobby days because we don't have enough members in the state. And I think if people could study the webpage, it's www.laaclu.org.
Say that twice.
Okay, www.laaclu.org.
So, L.A. meaning Louisiana. Louisiana, yep. ACLU. Okay.
Yep. And if people go to that, you can study our issues. You can look at all of our past cases and see what we've done. There's actually, if you need to file a complaint, we're here. We go through every complaint. Sometimes we can't answer every one of them, as in take the case, but we go through every complaint. And if there's something wrong and something that you think your constitutional rights have been violated, your Bill of Rights, please contact us. We're here to help, and we also hope that once you learn what we do, once the community learns what we do more, there's more a positive outlook on what we do, because we really believe in what we do.
Now, is your funding exclusively from members' membership, or you have other sources of funds?
We can get grants every now and then. We do apply for grants through our development director, but one thing that's really important to know, we mainly work off of member donations. And the thing is we obviously do not get any governmental funds because we sue the government. So,
of course.
Yeah. But you're surprised. People actually think that we get governmental funds or help from the government. But we are a nonprofit.
Yes.
So we do, if you can donate, that, you know, that's great, too. You can do that through the website.
And that's tax-deductible.
Tax-deductible. The memberships are not. So if you want to join and then donate some other money to the donate fund, that would be great.
Well, our organization is very similar to yours regarding funding, and neither of us has the advantage of having people who do tithing. And so in many cases, we and ACLU may be up against some well-funded opposition because they do have access that we don't have.
Yes.
Well, the time has come again for us to conclude this program. I do want to thank you folks who've been watching, and be with us again next week.